There, guys, I'm going to do a titration today. Jacob Fehler is going to help me. I have a number of students here. Today's an AP testing day, so we have a few people are here, but we have less than our class, so I'm taking advantage of this time. So Jacob Fehler is going to help us do a titration. Jacob, first thing we got to do is we got to have good safety, right? So we got to go to the goggle cabin. We've got to put on some goggles. Let's do that. I'm going to go to get mine real quick.
Over here.
So he goes, he gets on a pair of goggles, all right? Step one, complete. He puts them on, he makes sure that, you know, there's no openings in the holes at the top. He makes sure that they're tight to his face, a little uncomfortable, right? That way if, you know, acid or any type of base was to come into contact with him, he's a safe young man. All right, so we got to gather our things that we need now to be able to do a titration. So the first thing we need then is a pull stand. So he comes to the back of the room, and in this cabinet in the back of the room right here, he's going to find pull stands. Right here. So he's going to grab one of those, grab a pull stand, take it to his table, and he's going to put that together. This one, you'll go right up front here. So he's going to go right here. He's going to put a white piece of paper on the top of the pull stand. I'll explain why that's important later on. All right, the next thing he needs to obtain is he needs to obtain an Erlenmeyer flask. Erlenmeyer flasks are over here.
Erlenmeyer flasks are the best.
There we go. Erlenmeyer flask, yep. I would recommend he probably gets a 150 or 250 milliliter one, depending on how much titrating he wants to do. That's a big one, you know. I might even suggest you get a 125. We're not going to be using volumes that are that significant. So 125, he brings it over to his place. All right, next thing he's going to do is he's going to get a graduated cylinder. Graduated cylinders are located right here. He's going to get a little one, a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder. He's then going to go over to where the acids are. The acids are underneath the hood. He's going to measure off 5 milliliters of acid. Droppers are located. I'll put a dropper right there. In fact, there is one there for him. And he's going to put 5 milliliters of acid.
Jacob
Fehler has measured off 5 milliliters of acid. Now, what I would suggest that he does, right in that same graduated cylinder, drop a couple drops of phenolphthalein in there. Now, it is very important that Jacob Fehler does this. He puts the phenolphthalein in with the acid. That is a very important part. Phenolphthalein, when exposed to base, will turn bright pink, okay? So he puts a couple of drops, and literally a couple drops, you know, like a little bit goes a long way. So he puts a couple of drops in, boom. All right, takes that, takes it to his table. Now's the most important part. Jacob Fehler is now going to obtain the things he needs to actually do the titration. He's going to obtain a burette and a burette clamp. Now, the last time I bought burettes, I will tell you, they run somewhere around $125 to $150 each. And the tips on them are pretty darn sensitive. You break it, you buy it. All right. So, back here is where you're going to find, right in this drawer right here, you're going to find burette clamps. He's going to grab one of those. Then he's going to go over, he's going to get a burette. Now, like I said, the burettes, $125 to $150 each. And so one of the things we do in order to be able to keep them safe is we remove the stopcocks from them every single time. There is a letter. This letter says D. That will correspond to a stopcock that is also lettered D. What he's going to do is he's going to grab the stopcock, grab the appropriate burette, grab his clamps. We're going to head over to our workstation. And we're going to put it together. You stop. Have this together so that now it's, you know, you put the stopcock through the glass portion, you put on the nut. Now, you want to have this tight enough to the point where it's pretty tight. You're not going to have liquid coming out. But you also need to be able to turn this without putting pressure on it. The way my students break it is they break the tips off because they can't do this motion. Now, perpendicular, like I have it now, is closed. Parallel like this
is open. We're going to place inside of here sodium hydroxide base. So as such, we don't want it to be placed in here and run right out. So I'm going to turn it perpendicular so it's closed. Then what we're going to do is we take the clamps, close it, and place it like so. Now we want to be able to see the graduates on the burette here. It reads 50 milliliters here, 0 milliliters here. So what we want to do now is we're going to get a funnel. We're going to obtain 10 milliliters of sodium hydroxide, and then we'll be back to you in a second.
All right.
So sodium hydroxide, right? You need to obtain a beaker and a long stem funnel. I just wanted you to know where these things are. We're then going to place inside of this beaker exactly, actually it doesn't even matter. We want to go, so you'll see there's little graduates on it, right? 20, 40, 60, 80, can you see that in here? You want to take and put, you know, somewhere, you know, before the 20 mark when you go over and get your base. If you end up with more than 10 milliliters, that's okay because we're going to read that on the burette anyway. So Jacob Tiller, what he's going to do now is he's going to take and he's going to fill his burette with base. Now, it will not matter about if you measured what was in the beaker exactly. We're going to find out in a moment how much there is. Okay, so I have made it today so that this base is 0.5 molar and this acid is 0.5 molar. So theoretically, 5 milliliters of acid, when placed inside of this Erlenmeyer flask, should be titrated by exactly, or pretty close, to 5 milliliters of this base. And that's what I want you to practice. You're going to get 5 milliliters, a little bit of acid, and you're just going to practice this process. So I take a look at my burette. Jacob, what does that read?
I'm 43.
So,
between 43 and 42.
Yep, so remember, it goes down to get to 50. So I agree with him, and there's a little meniscus. It's like a little bubble, and he wants to read it at the very bottom. He said it's between 42 and 43. Jacob, I agree with you, and if I was even being more specific, would you agree with me? I read about 42.6.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I would do is on your little white sheet of paper, I might even record that number, 42.6, because that's your starting value. You then take your acid and you place it inside of your Erlenmeyer. And I guess I'm taking away your equipment together. Like you should be the one to demonstrate that.
I just want to work this out, okay?
All right. Now remember, we put phenolphthalein inside of this graduated cylinder, right? And what we're going to do is we're going to add this base. Now I will tell you, I'm going to have Jacob add the first 4 milliliters really fast. So he's going to take this from 42.6... or 42.5-ish, down to 46.5. Please do that quickly. Now, we're going to do a little magic trick here, almost. So, we're going all the way down. Now, this is nice because we know this one. Did you go all the way to 46.5?
46.
Oh, never mind. Keep going. It's all the way to like 47. It shouldn't. I mean, if Dre didn't mess up these solutions, then we should be okay. So see how that looks pink? We should swish it around, right? And it goes away. How you know you're done is when the pink color stays permanently. Now the best titrations are the ones that have the most faint pink that stays. So now he's going to go little by little until it stays pink. So he might put a couple of drops and switch it around. A couple of drops, switch it around. Switch it around, see if what happens. Alright. Alright, it stayed. Now, I will tell you, Jacob probably went one drop too far. Okay? If he wanted it to be that absolute light pink color. Now, Jacob, let's read this thing and see what it says. This thing says 47.2. So I will tell you that the 0.5 molar sodium hydroxide that was made by my student teacher is a little short of 0.5 molar. All right, it would probably read probably somewhere around 0.45 or so. But it's pretty close, and it'll give you a chance to practice. So then what you would do is obtain more base if you need to in order to do it again and practice again. And that is an acid-base titration.